Let's start with Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, as we discussed in the previous lecture. So he was one of the torchbearers in making of Pakistan. So what did Sir Syed Ahmed Khan do and why he got so popular and what were his achievements and who was he? Let's talk about that. Sir Syed Ahmed Khan was a teacher and a politician. And he was very active in the education sector. He also had established a college, school and university. And he wanted everybody, all the Muslims, to get educated. He was a philosopher as well. He was also a social reformer, where he used to help others. Social reformer mean that khidmat-e-khalq-e bahut kaam karte the. He founded the school that would later become Aligarh University. He gave two nation theory. So as I told you, he founded a school that later upgraded itself to university level, and the university name is Aligarh Muslim University. I believe that some of you might already know about it. So he also gave the two nation theory, which we will discuss after in the end of this lecture. So what was Sir Syed Ahmed Khan two nation theory that we discussed in the previous slide? The two nation theory is the basis of creation of Pakistan. So two nation theory thi unki basis pe Pakistan hame mila aur bana jo in logon ne bhi banane ke liye jiddojahd ki Pakistan, it was on the basis of two nation theory. The two nation theory in its simplest way means the cultural, political, religious, economic and social dismilitaries between two major communities, Hindus and Muslims of the subcontinent. So what did two nation theory believe? That Muslims or Hindus jo hain wo do alag alag nation hain, they have different values and cultures, and all the things that they have are different. They have different culture, they have different political mindsets, they have different religion, economic values, social values, all of these things are different among themselves, and they should have two different countries for themselves as well. Okay, so why did Sir Syed Ahmed Khan develop two nation theory? So Sir Syed also increased the political awareness in Muslims in the subcontinent, because Muslims at that time were not well aware. Bahut sare Muslims, they were not even getting education because they believed that un logo ko Urdu se bahut mohabbat thi us time ke Muslimano ko. So they wanted to study in Urdu only, whereas British rule shuru ho gaya tha and Britishers were emphasizing English in a lot of areas. As we all know, even today Britishers are way ahead us than in science and technology and all of that those fields. So us zamane mein bhi aise hi tha ke Britishers were ahead of us in sciences and all of these things. And उसकी वजह से मुसलमान इंग्लिश में पढ़ना नहीं चाहते थे और ब्रिटिशर्स उर्दू में पढ़ाना नहीं चाहते थे. सो इस वजह से जो है मुसलमानों में एजुकेशन भी कम थी, पॉलिटिकल अवेयरनेस भी कम थी. एंड मुसलमान उस टाइम पे बहुत मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द मुस्लिम्स बिलीव्ड दैट पाकिस्तान जो है पाकिस्तान नहीं बनना चाहिए, एंड मुस्लिम्स एंड हिंदूज एंड ऑल ऑफ दोज अदर रिलीजन्स शुड लिव हैप्पीली इन द सेम एरिया सब कॉन्टिनेंट. दे डिडंट वांटेड टू द डिवीजन ऑफ द सब कॉन्टिनेंट. मोस्ट ऑफ द मुस्लिम्स डिड नॉट वांटेड द डिवीजन ऑफ सब कॉन्टिनेंट. तो इट वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम एंड ही वॉन्टेड टू इंक्रीज पॉलिटिकल अवेयरनेस इन मुस्लिम्स. At first he believed in Hindu-Muslim unity, but later resolved to two nation theory. तो पहले वो भी believe करते थे कि मुस्लिम और हिंदू साथ रहें, unity से रहें, but later he gave the theory of two nation theory. Two nation theory का मतलब ये है कि दो कौमी नज़र है, मतलब they were two nations, right? Hindu and Muslims. तो he gave the idea of two nation theory, and he thought that both of the nations should be divided and they have their own separate homeland. In 1885 Indian National Congress was set up. So ye jo party set up hui thi, it claimed to be the body of every Indian regardless of religion, but later on it started protecting the rights of Hindus only, or they weren't considering the other religions, mainly Hindus. Hindus ki wo log baat nahi sun rahe the, they were only favoring their own religion, which was Hindu. So why do you think two nation theory has such a significant importance in our history? So this is the reason. The two nation theory is the basis of creation of Pakistan. According to this theory, Muslims and Hindus are two separate nations by definition. Muslims have their own customs, religion and tradition, and from social and moral view, Muslims are different from Hindus, and therefore Muslims should be able to have their own separate homeland in which Islam is the dominant religion, being segregated from Hindus. The two nation theory advocated by the All India Muslim League in the forming of principle of Pakistan movement. So two nation theory ka maqsad yahi tha in short words, that they believe that Muslims they have different religion, un logo ka taur tareeqa alag hai, rehne ka tradition alag hai, social values alag hai, har cheez alag hai than that of the Hindus, and they believe that dono ka jo na alag religion hona chahiye, and we should get separated from Hindus, segregated matlab alag ho jana chahiye. And the two nation theory advocated, to jo ye jo All India Muslim League एक पार्टी पार्टी बनी थी, they advocated the two nation theory, and it was one of the founding principle of the Pakistan movement. पाकिस्तान मूवमेंट से ही हमें पाकिस्तान हासिल